My darlings, welcome back to Mystic Monday with me, your host, Aurora Dawn. We are going to jump right into your tarot card reading. My crystals are still buried. I'm a bit of transition right now. So I will be unearthing them this week and listing some beauties for you. I miss them probably as much as you do. So pick a number. 1, 2, 3 or 4. Pick 1, pick 2, or pick 3. Sorry, 1, 2, 3, or 4. We're not doing 4. We're doing 3. We're doing 3. Pick a number. 1, 2, or 3. I just like 4. 4 is my number. Yes, I love 4. So, but anyway, pick a number because I don't have crystals. So, 1, 2, 3, or 4. And the reading will be for each one of your numbers, darling. This is about this week, something you will encounter this week. All right, here we go. We're going to mix it up and we're going to start with number 3 instead of number 1. Number 3, it's the countdown. We've got the Lovers number 3. Oh, that's so beautiful, the Lovers card. Well, it's very intense, my friend. I mean, when you get the Lovers card, it's basically like you are going through a gateway. You are going through an initiation. Whatever you are going through this week, oh boy, it's going to change your life, my friend. It calls for a decision. It calls for boldness. It calls for following your heart. Without question, are you brave? Let me ask you, darling, are you brave? Because your bravery is going to be tested this week, number 3. Whether it is with another person who comes into your life, or it is a job opportunity, a vacation, a sort of inner invitation to start a new project. Oftentimes, though, I will say 9 times out of 10, this does involve another person. They may not be a lover, though. They may be like a twin. They may be a brother or a sister. Okay, but this is a soul person. This is a soul friend of yours coming into your life. And I warn you that this kind of a soul friend, they teach you lessons and they push you along and they bring great drama into your heart. It does not mean, though, that they are to be your partner or that they are, or that you are just to disappear with them into ecstasy. I mean, that doesn't last anyway. This is about getting it done. Get it done, darling, whatever it is. Do it, go for it. All right, fantastic. Now, number 2, what do we have for lucky number 2 today? We've got the Queen of Pentacles reversed. All right, so a little bit of money here, money concerns. This is mommy worrying about paying the bills. This is also like if you have a person in your life who is a friend or a girlfriend or whatever, a partner, or even this can also fall under a lot of male behavior if there's like really detail-oriented concern, and also the word is like when somebody's clinging to you and making you feel like claustrophobic and you want to run away. Okay, that's a lot of Queen of Pentacles reversed energy, all right? Sometimes she can be holding, clinging is really the word. I mean, she's clinging too tightly because, you know, she's very concerned with money and with security and with having a plan. And so this week, there might be a little bit of a tumble jumble going on, and there's either you or somebody in your life is telling you to be scared or you know, everything's not okay. The key to here is to breathe and to trust that everything is okay, because the thing with Queen of Pentacles is that she always goes too far ahead, okay? She's not in the moment oftentimes because she's always doing a calculation. She's got this calculator going on in her mind at all times. And this is a calculator in relationship tips in the checkbook, in everything. If like calculating what line you're going to stand in at the grocery store in order to get to your next event on time, and calculating what your partner or your child's going to do based on past experience. Now, this is her greatest weakness, is that when you start calculating people's actions and any actions in your life based on your past experience, you're sort of locking them down into that limitation of your own beliefs and your own power of creation. And so what's important, if you are going to calculate, is to come up with a new calculation, okay? Come up with some new form of math or something that hasn't been invented yet. Some miraculous calculation. That is my advice for you, number two. Miraculous calculation. It is truly a thing, but you have to let go. You have to let go of what you know and say, in my heart, I know this can be different than what my mind tells me. And I trust in the organic process of life, and everything is coming together to support me. Everything is coming together to support me. There are no mistakes. All right. Now, number one. Lucky number one. What do we have? Oh, boy. We have the Six of Swords. Sorry, number one. There's still a bit more work to do. Well, so the Six of Swords is when you've been caught in a little bit of a difficult situation. You're trying to move forward. This can often be a family affair, okay? It can often be a family affair where there's been family trauma. A lot of times this just simply exists in your head, as many things do when the Swords cards come up, because those are your mind. And so this is oftentimes when, you know, you're at the gate, you're ready to go, you're ready to leave something behind, but you keep getting pulled back in, okay? You're ready to sail off into, you know, the smoother waters to make a great transition. But this just says, not yet, dear, not yet. So what this indicates is take care, have patience. Trust that it will be your time soon, but there's still a little bit more to learn in the situation. You would not be stuck in the situation if there were not more to learn. Remember, everything, every challenge, every difficulty, it's there for us. It's for us. It is a gift. It is a gift. And so we must take the difficulty that we are stuck in and see it as a gift and say, what can I learn here? How can I become stronger? How can I become more balanced today? How can I bring more joy, more harmony, more love into this situation that lacks all of those things? That is in your power to do, number one. All right, my beauties, it's been so wonderful to see you again and to read for you. Please let me know what you thought about the reading, if it was helpful for you. I love to hear from you. And so have a wonderful work a week. Don't have a wonderful work? Well, have a wonderful work too, if you're doing work this week. Okay, I'm going to have a wonderful work week. I'm going to work, it's going to be a good week, and I'm going to have fun, and I will be thinking of you. I love you all.